Ayurveda .com. Today we are discussing about different dosage forms that are there in Ayurvedic pharmaceutics. A dosage form is a form of medicine in which it is being prescribed to patient. For example, kashaya is a dosage form, or churna, or syrup, or avlaiha. So these are the different dosage forms that we use. So we have got a lot of dosage forms. We have got kashaya, we have got churna, we have got kalka, that is paste. We have got swarasa or juice extract. We have got aswarishta, we have got avlaiha. So what do you think, sir, is the basis for all these different dosage forms, and whether all these different dosage forms are really necessary for Ayurvedic pharmaceutics considering today's scenario?
Yes. The dosage form is termed as kalpana in Ayurvedic pharmaceutics. Kalpana refers to various kinds of preparations prepared based upon the necessity of the chemical constituents required for the particular purpose. In Sanskrit it is termed kalpaha vidhihi vidhane samskare, means depending upon the sequence, depending upon the step, or depending upon the special pharmaceutical process, that is samskara, what kind of chemical constituents are required in a particular media, accordingly we are preparing some specific pharmaceutical preparations, like as you have mentioned, it will be swarasa, fresh juice, kalka, the medicated paste, kvatha decoctions, hima, cold infusions, fanta, hot infusions, and their derived formulations like taila, means medicated oil, ghrita, medicated ghee, asava and arishta, naturally fermented preparations, the avaleha or lehya, which is the liquibles or lintas, and powders, churna kalpana, kshara, lavana, likewise so many preparations are there, and in the primordial texts like Charaka Samhita, more than 160 such formulations are mentioned. And while explaining the utility of each and every such formulation, Acharya Charaka correctly refers Satatyat Swadu Abhavadva Patyam Veshatvam Apriya Kalpana Vidhisthaisthai Priyatvam Gamayet Punaha, means every individual is having particular liking and particular disliking. Depending upon the like and dislike of the patients, we should go for some formulations. A person who is not liking swarasa or fresh juice, we should not compel him to take the swarasa, because psychological factors do have an impact on the medicine.
Yes, because swarasa will be usually bitter and very pungent in taste, and patient might not be able to take it.
Yes, but the difficulty is, for a patient of diabetes, we can't tell him to take asava and arishta in a larger amount, because they themselves have the sugar content. By the time we can modify that into asava and arishta into some particular formation like kashaya or tablet, and we can administer. And in a particular individual, according to the stage of the disorder, we should select the formulation. For example, in acute condition, we cannot administer any kind of oleaginous preparations like ghrita, taila or avaleha. Whereas in chronic conditions, administration of the preparations like swarasa or kalka, they are not helpful. In chronic conditions, we should give asavarishta preparations, or else lehya preparations, otherwise ghrita and taila preparations.
The reason that you are telling acute conditions why ghrita, taila or avalehas are not to be used is because they take a longer period to undergo digestion. Why is that?
Yes, one reason, as you have correctly pointed out, the nature of the digesting capacity. Second is nature of the illness. When the morbidity is more in the body, and if the person is already having indigestion, he can't digest the medicaments what we have administered. That is particularly referred as the aushadha jirana. The medicine itself can be causing indigestion, and further the morbidity, doshatva may increase and the condition may be worsened. Whereas in initial stages of the diseases, usually we prefer kashaya or decoctions, because kashaya by nature itself, they are having the capacity to digest, or they are having digestive and carminative nature, that is called Deepana Pachana effect. Whereas natural Deepana Pachana effect will not be there in Taila or Bhuta Kalpanas. Likewise, whenever the individual is having sufficient digestive capacity or carminative benefit, unnecessary adoption of asava and arishta may be harmful because it may damage the tissues. So we should go for the lehya kalpana or hrita kalpana in such context. And further, whenever according to the doshic dominance also, whenever kapha is dominant, we should prefer churna yogas. Whenever vata is dominant, we can prefer taila or hrita yogas, otherwise kashaya yogas. Whenever pitta is dominant, we can go for hima kalpanas or fanta kalpana likewise.
So that's why even in the preparation of panchakarma procedure, that is the puro karma, wherein we give large amount of kritas, even before that, you know, deepana pachana, aha pachana is done, and deepana is done, deepana in the sense the patient's digestive strength is further stimulated by administering some digestive chunas. So that is also.
Yes, that is correctly mentioned. Deepane pachane sneha itam svedaischa parishkata shodhe shodhane kale yathasanna vinirhare. Before the administration of any of the purificatory therapies like vamana, that is emesis, virechana, purgation, nasya, arise, likewise, first of all we should give the deepana pachana, digestive and carminative medicaments. Then it is brought to the kosha, means the main organ, main site of the doshas. For vata it is pakvashya, large intestine is the site. For pitta it is the nabhi, or what we consider as the middle part of the intestine. Or for kapha, amashya, that is samak, is the main site. We are bringing the morbidity doshas to the main site, and from that it is expelled out of the body. In that regard, the particular kind of medicine what we are using, it is having equally importance.